Well, we're now in day four of the eruption, and so far we haven't had any major problems. That being said, it is still causing some problems with the weather. Yesterday we had what are called pyrocumulus clouds and even pyrocumulonimbus clouds, which are pyrocumulus clouds that eventually produce thunderstorms. Although they are most commonly associated with fires, we have experienced them with the Kileauea eruption before back in 2018, and now we've seen them with this eruption. Joining us this morning to discuss this phenomenon is Robert Bolin, a meteorologist with the National Weather Service office, forecast office in on UH Manoa. Good morning, Robert. Thanks again for joining us.
Good morning, Chevy. Good to be here.
Absolutely. So how long have you been a meteorologist first?
Oh, geez. Back to my days with the Hawaii Air National Guard, where I started out, I'd say 33 years.
33 years. How often have you seen pyrocumulus or pyrocumulonimbus clouds?
You know, in Hawaii, it's pretty rare. I think other than the 2018 eruption, as you mentioned, it was mainly on the mainland with wildfires.
So, I mean, these are pretty rare, as you mentioned, usually associated with fires. I mean, to get rain, we need lift in the atmosphere. To get thunderstorms, we need more lift. Heat from daytime heating can do that, but lava is much hotter, of course. So are thunderstorms generated from this type of heat more dangerous than typical thunderstorms on the Big Island, would you say?
I wouldn't say more dangerous. I'd say the heat is making it more common than it would without the heat. You know, when you need an unstable environment to create these thunderstorms, all you need is some moisture and a good lifting mechanism. And, you know, that heat provides a pretty good lifting mechanism.
And today we do have the moisture still in place, right? And we have the chance for this to repeat itself again today?
There are slight chances for thunderstorms over the peaks today as well, but the moisture is a little bit lower than it is was yesterday, so it's a little nuance there as to whether or not we'll get as much activity as we saw yesterday.
All right, let's shift gears and talk about the fog. The fog has been staying above 10,000 feet. Is there anything in the forecast that would indicate that this would change for today or for tomorrow?
Yeah, it's a challenge with the VOG forecast, because first we're starting with an elevated source and trying to figure out mechanisms and how this is going to mix down to like below 5,000 feet where the people live has been a challenge. And as the source moves a little bit further down slope, that becomes a little bit more likely. But we're relying on the public and, of course, sensors to detect this VOG so that we can maybe speak to it with more confidence in our forecast.
Okay, that
it's
makes
kind of
sense.
A wait and see approach.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it just needs something to pull it down. I mean, it could be rain showers, actually, but as you said, there's a little bit less moisture in the air, so maybe we won't see the rain today. Anyway, where should people go to get the latest about the eruption, especially those living on the Big Island and that could eventually be in harm's way? Where would they get the information that would benefit them the most?
Yeah, that's a great question, Chevy, and what we've been trying to put out to the public is Hawaii Civil Defense, and you can get to Hawaii Civil Defense website from hawaiicounty.gov, is a great resource for alerts where the lava is located. You can sign up for alerts on your cell phone, so if there's ever emergency situations developing, Hawaii County Civil Defense can alert you via text messaging. So that you can be take action as soon as possible. But and in preparation for these hazards is also on the website, as well as emergency proclamations from the mayor of Hawaii and the governor.
Okay, sounds good. I'll keep reminding people of that, because there's a similar thing. You can go to the HVO website and get text alerts on the eruption reports. Thank you again, Robert, for joining us this morning. We hope to be able to see you again soon.
Thank you, Chevy. Take care.
All right, Robert.